a little bit about the rewrite, and then I have some more statistics on the system status, and then a slide on what we have planned for 2012. So the rewrite has been and continues to be a significant level of effort for us right now. It's probably taking up the majority of the technical time, technical team's time. Although I must say that, you know, we still spend a lot of time maintaining the system, maintaining the old system, and taking care of issues that that come up on a regular basis with support tickets. Our support team, Patricia Feeney and Vishali Patel, service hundreds of tickets that come in from you all on a regular basis, and answering the small questions from small publishers and big publishers to the big problems that that come up from some of our larger members. So taking care of routine business is still a big part of what we do. The query system has been really fully deployed. We're real happy with the way that that came out. It was deployed during the first part of the year. I'd say we really had a shakedown for about 3 months, making sure that it worked as well as, if not better than, the old system, and also had to accommodate some changes that we weren't aware of, that the in the way the old system performed. But the query part of the project is more or less complete. Now it's into just continual refinement and improvement. The deposit system, early in this year, we recognized that the Big Bang approach probably was not the best way to proceed. So we divided the project into two phases. The first phase, which is nearing completion right now, was to take the old code in the old Adapon environment and framework and port it to the new Crossref framework and environment. And that has been completed. It is now just in some final testing. Obviously, we want to make sure that it really is correct, works properly, doesn't have any significant bugs and issues in it once it's deployed. Unlike the query system, the query system, it was very easy for us to turn it on for a little while, and if it had problems, turn it off and go back to the old one. With the deposit system, we really don't have that luxury. Once we turn it on, it has to stay on, and we want to make sure we have it right. Our development, our pace of development has been moderate. I think we're being quite cautious with the rollouts and the deployment. This usually is a trade-off of time versus money, and I think we're probably falling a little bit more on the side of taking time and to get it right. So during the rest of 2012 and 11 into 12, we'll deploy the first phase of the deposit system, and then next year will be a significant rewrite of the schema portion of the deposit system. This will impact the code. There will be a new amount of work to rewrite the deposit system as a result of the schema changes, but this is going to put us in a much better position moving forward. So some statistics. This is for the 12 months from October to October, and you can see that this chart is shows them. We have an external monitoring service. Most people use external monitoring services to watch their systems. And what you see here are the major services that we provide. And then these are just some internal monitors that let us know how things are going under the hood. But generally speaking, for the 12 months ending October, 99.9% for deposit availability. That's 3 hours of downtime in a 12 month period. We're very happy with that. Open URL queries, 99.972%, 2 hours of downtime. Metadata queries, represented by this item, 99.67. So that's our troublesome child. We're gonna keep working on him, but it represents 26 hours of downtime over a period of a year. Now that's a very, very respectable uptime for the service that we have, and for and you know, the membership seems to be quite happy with this. We receive almost no complaints and no issues about the availability of the system. So if I don't hear any real complaints and noise, I'll take that as good news. This chart represents DOI clicks. As Ed said, the numbers are quite impressive. These are end users. As Ed also said, this is with the crawler traffic removed, which is quite sizable. But we should all remember that the crawler traffic is probably very valuable as well. So the amount of overall DOI activity is bigger than these numbers, and also quite important. But if you look here, we have the average, the monthly average in 2009, 30 million. The monthly average in 2010, just under 40 million. And the monthly averages so far, or the monthly totals for this year so far. So as Ed's chart showed, everything is still going up. It's difficult to explain some of the peaks that may happen. Not really sure what causes that. We do have the ability to do in-depth investigations, and we do that for certain publishers when they ask questions about why something has happened. So if you do have some questions about your monthly resolution reports that you receive, by all means, contact support and we'll look into it. This chart might be a little hard to see, but this is the performance chart. This is query performance over the period starting in July of this year. So this is the new query system. You can see that most of the activity falls within the half a second to 1 second range. So our performance has been incredibly stable, and this is a figure that I'm quite happy with. We've tried to stay at the sub 1 second level since the beginning, and we're doing pretty well. We had a period of time in the middle of the year here where we were tuning our load balancer, and we had to undo that tuning. didn't quite have the desired goal, but all told, the performance is quite nice. And given the fact that our volume is up, I think that's also a good testament to the system. This is the query volume that we've been seeing. If you look in past years, the total for the years were in the 400 million, 400 and a half million figure. Now, the monthly totals for this year, 50 million, 66 million, 70 million, 60 million, 96 million. So the new query system is handling a tremendously increased volume of traffic, double really the amount of traffic. But there is some things to question here, and we need to study that further. The matching rates. The matching rates typically were in the 40% was quite steady. We had gotten to that point. Now we're down back into the 20%. For library members, their matching rate seems to be about the same, 60% versus historically in the 60% area, and affiliates also in the 40% range, and more or less in the 40% range now. It's our publisher members who have fallen down to essentially half. So the thing that might jump out at you, you might ask, okay, so are we just re-querying again with the same bad queries that don't match? That could be the case. We are collecting much more robust log data now, and so we can do analysis to find out what's going on here. We will do that when we get a little bit more time to spend on that kind of activity. But the volumes are great. The matching rate is still good given that volume, and the fact that the DOI click rate is still so high means that the DOIs are getting out there. But we will be looking at why this is happening. This is just another chart of the query volume. You can see how it's been spiking up at the end of the year. This is good. Deposit times. This has probably been our biggest challenge this year. Elsevier and others, so it's not just Elsevier, but Elsevier primarily has been depositing all of their, redepositing all of their content with references, which means they're creating cited by link relationships. They are, to date, we've probably created about 65 to 70 million cited by relationships with the Elsevier data. We've probably got about 30 million stored queries, that is a cited by relationship that didn't get recreated because we didn't find the match, but those queries are saved in the system and they'll be regularly rerun, potentially to hopefully match in the future. And we're about halfway done, a little bit more than halfway done with the Elsevier data. These times are reflect the Elsevier redeposit excluded. It's not in these numbers. So their data is following a whole separate timeline. But you can see that for most of the months of this year, large majority of the deposited content gets into the system and gets processed in under an hour. Actually, most of it is significantly under an hour. This chart here is 5 minutes, and then this one is 5 minutes to an hour. So you can see that between these two, you're probably 40% plus 20, so 60% of the content, 60% of the deposits are getting processed very quickly. There is a slice of deposits that take longer, 1 to 6 hours, and this is the result of the fact that a lot, Taylor & Francis, Springer, Wiley, other large publishers have been making some significant redeposit of their content. We've been working on the queue management so that this doesn't become a bottleneck and so that all members get a good shot at getting their data through the system. And I think in the end of July, we made some changes that have made some real improvements there. Out here, you can see that there are some deposits, and this right here probably represents a Taylor & Francis deposit, I think, where they sent in 1.2 million DOIs to be updated in one big slug of data, and we just cranked through it. So a lot of their files just sat, had to wait and get processed through the system. DOI deposits by back year and current articles, you can see the split still is biased towards back. Back year deposits. Cited by linking. In cited by linking, as with the Elsevier deposits and other member deposits, I want to stress that this is not just a result of the Elsevier deposit, although that is a significant amount of data, but other members are also doing this as well. We've got 248 members participating. Over 225 million cited by relationships. We expect probably at least another 50 million in the rest of the journal data that we're processing now. We also have all of their book data sitting and waiting to go, and we will process that once we're done with the journal data. Unstructured citations are not yet being processed in the deposit of references. This decision is primarily due to the need to get through the bulk of the work and then go back to these kinds of queries. These take quite a bit longer to run. We use a variety of technologies on processing these kinds of citations, one of which is Eneris technology, and I want to be working with Bruce soon to take another stab at getting some of that that technology more efficient. But unstructured citations essentially are, you know, just a free-flowing textual reference, and we have the ability to take that, break it down, parse it out to the fields, and then run queries on it. Changes being made to improve data retrieval. With the growth in the amount of data, we're now being confronted with challenges in providing members with efficient interfaces to get this data. Some of the things that were put in place originally were fine when the data wasn't quite so voluminous. Those things are starting to get strained. And one of the things that we're looking at is using OAI PMH to allow members to retrieve in bulk all of the cited by information to their content. So you can make a request to CrossRef and say, here's my journal. Give me all of the cited by links to this journal. And you will get the data back in a way that OAI PMH allows. It allows for segmented return of data. It's a very, very powerful and useful technique. So in 2012, obviously we're going to be continuing work on the rewrite, particularly phase two of the deposit rewrite. We want to improve the deposit logging. When you make deposits, you get a log file back. That's for the deposit as a whole. I think that needs some improvement to provide greater granularity into the deposit process that took place. I want to start analyzing those logs that I mentioned a little while ago. We need a new member user prefix ownership model. Our current model is kind of crude. It's based on prefixes. It's really not the right way to go. We're going to be productionizing the implementation of Crossmark. Right now, the bulk of the Crossmark system is implemented in a beta system that Jeff put together. We want to bring that into the main line of code that is the main proper Crossref system. We want to rework conflicts. Conflicts are a problem for all of us. We really need to pay attention to conflicts to make sure that the matching rates are what they should be. Cited by, as I mentioned, we're going to focus on OAI PMH for harvesting. Try to get away from using email for messaging. That causes a lot of trouble for members when they get a few hundred thousand emails in an hour. Their email systems don't tend to like that very well. And then start processing the unstructured references. We have a simple text query API that we have been working on since last annual member meeting. We had a number of people who requested this. It's just unfortunately has been kind of low on the priority poll to work on, but we're close to having that ready. We have a PDF processing tool that Jeff's group has been working on. Those of you that attended, and I think Jeff might be talking about this a little bit later, this is going to be a new service for small publishers that should be really quite a boon to how smaller members try to get their data into Crossref. And we need to simplify the usage of a lot of our technologies. We have a lot of APIs that have sort of grown organically over the years, and that tends to get a little bit frayed or cluttered looking, and we kind of want to pull that all back and make it a little bit more streamlined and uniform. So that's the end of the system update. I want to just mention here that we have a support site, support.crossref.org. If you go to support.crossref.org, essentially what you do is you sign up for an account. It's just your email address. And on support, we have forums. There's a variety of forums that we post messages to. This is the place to get technical information. We no longer really use the technical working group email server. It's all being done through the forums on support. So please go there and sign up for the forums. That's the end of the presentation. You want to take questions? Questions? Okay. So, thank you.